In this session, we are giving one example of phases of a compiler. In our earlier video, we have discussed that compiler does the compilation or translation process through multiple phases. And they were lexical analyzer, syntax analyzer, we are having this semantic analyzer, intermediate code generator, then we will be having our code optimizer, then the last one will be our code generator. So from the source program to the target program, these are the phases. And there are other two phases are there. One is your symbol table manager, which is linked with all the phases here. And there is another, that is the error handler. So it will be connected with all the phases accordingly to produce the respective error message whenever error will get produced. So to explain this one into more detailed form, let us consider one example. So let us suppose there is one high level language written statement, that is price colon equal to amount plus rate into 50. Let us suppose this price, amount and rate are of the type real, that means they can have some fraction part, and this 50 is purely in integer. Okay, so just keep this one in mind, we will be taking care of that issue. So lexical analyzer will take this particular statement as input and it will produce the series of tokens as output. So it is producing this price will be detected as identifier 1, identifier means variable. So identifier 1, and this colon equal to is this one, then amount has been detected as your say identifier 2, plus has been kept as it is, and then rate has been detected is another variable. So it has been detected as identifier number 3, into is there, and that is another integer data 50. So it has taken 50 as a constant. So this is the output of the lexical analyzer. Okay, different lexical analyzer can interpret this line in different way. Okay, now it has come to the syntax analyzer. Syntax analyzer will check whether these tokens are in the proper order or not according to the grammar. So each and every language, programming language, high level language should have some dedicated grammar, and the grammar will be having set of production rules. So as a result of that, it will check whether all these tokens are in the proper grammatical, according to the grammar maintained by the language, the sequence is according to the grammar or not. So to check that one, it will construct one parse tree. So this is known as a parse tree. So now it is doing in this way. So it is my left hand side, there is my colon equal to, that is the assignment operator, and there is my right hand side. So it will do in this way. So this assignment operator, left hand side is ID1, and this is my right hand side. Right hand side is having ID3 into 50, ID2 plus. So now it will be done in this way. So ID2 plus ID3 into 50. So now it has been done in this way. It will be done by the lexical analyzer. If lexical analyzer finds that tokens are in accordance to the grammar of the language, then it will pass it. Otherwise, it will produce the syntax error. Okay. So syntax analyzer will form this parse tree. So parse tree can be constructed from the top down approach or in the bottom up approach. Whatever it is, if the parse tree construction has been completed successfully, that means this particular statement is syntax error free. So now it will come to the semantic analyzer. So 50 was in integer, but these variables identifiers were of the type real data type. So that's why integer to real conversion will be done by the semantic analyzer. So it will change the meaning of this 50. So auto type upgrade will take place. So now intermediate code generator will take this one as input and it will produce the statement in some different format. Here they have used the three address statement. So we are having three addresses maximum. So this is the target address for the target. This is the addresses for the source. So it has been mentioned this one in this way. So temp is equal to colon equal to integer to real 50. So it will be, the code will be written in this way internally. So ID3 start temp 1. So temp 1 means 50 actually. So ID3 start temp 1 will be assigned to temp 2. And this temp 2 will be added with ID2. And that has been kept in temp 3. But it will be assigned onto the ID1. So ID1 assignment operator temp 3. So this is my intermediate code generated. So it will be taken as input by the code optimizer. So there are some redundancies here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, these four statements can also be expressed in the form of these two statements, and that will be done by the code optimizer. So it will bring some optimization of the code. So temp 1, SMAT operator ID3 star 50.0. So it has been converted to real. That means it can have the fractional part. And this temp 1 is containing this part. So as a result of that, you can go for this addition. So ID2 plus temp 1 will be assigned to ID1. So you see these four statements have got reduced to two statements, and that has been done by the code optimizer. So after code optimization, we are having the last phase remaining, that is the code generation. So this particular thing will be taken as input by the code generation. So code generator. So code generator will convert it to the respective registers number or registers name which is available in that particular architecture depending upon the target machine of the target program. So it is going for move F, that is float, move float R2 ID3. So ID3 means this one. So this one is getting moved to R2. Multiplication float mul F R2 star hash 5.0 for 50.0. So that means this hash is indicating that it is a real type of data. So now move F, so move float R1 ID2. So now ID2 has got moved to R1, and the multiplication is result is now still remaining in R2. So move F R1 ID2. So ID2 has come to R1. R1 is containing ID2. R2 is containing ID3 into 50. So add float R1 R2. So the sum is now in R1, but the sum should be kept in ID1. So move float ID1 R1. So this is the code generated. This is the generated code for the target machine depending upon the architecture of the target machine. So here in this particular process, this particular simple table will get generated. So here we are having three variables. So the respective symbol table will be marking them. So it will be doing the bookkeeping here. So price, amount and rate. So there is a symbol table. So if the program during execution finds that these variables are not defined, then obviously it will produce some error message. So this is a symbol table which will be doing the bookkeeping. So this is a data structure. We will be having a separate video on the symbol table later on. So price, amount and rate have got registered in the symbol table, which will contain the trace of the labels, identifiers or variables, literals and so on. So I think now the conception we are getting clear, that what are the phases of a compiler and which phase will be doing what if you give one statement of a high level language. So I think now conception is getting clear. Please watch our next videos on this particular compiler design. Thanks for watching this one.